हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रशांत सोलंकी फ्रॉम पीआर एजुकेशनल जोन एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग विथ अ डिग्री फॉर टुडे। लास्ट टाइम वी लर्न अबाउट द एडजेक्टिव एंड वी यूज इट हियर इन द डिग्री। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज डिग्री? वी कैन से दैट द डिग्री इज यूज टू शो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द एडजेक्टिव्स एंड or we can say that it is used to show the importance of adjective or for the comparison also we can say. And there are three types of degrees. First one is the positive degree. It is used to show the equivalency or the similarity between two things or many things. Comparative degree express comparison between the two things. Here please consider that comparative degree is used only for the comparison between two things or person, and the superlative degree express the highest quality among the many person or thing. So to understand that, we have take a three sentence here. First one is John Stalls. Here in the first sentence we can see that no comparison is done with John. So John is the superior in this sentence, and no one is compared. It is as it is, and we don't need to compare it with any other person or thing. So it is called the positive degree. And in the second sentence we can see that Peter is taller than John. So here we take a two subject, means two person, Peter and the John, and we compared each other, and after that we decided that Peter is taller than John. So here we made a comparison. So this is the comparative degree. And last one is the Harry is the tallest of the three, means among the three of them Harry is the tallest person. And which are the three? Harry, Peter and John. Among the all three person, Harry is the tallest person. So here Harry has the highest quality. So it is the example of the superlative degree. So we are explaining in the brief what is positive degree. So the positive degree of an adjective is the in its simple form, and it is used to denote the mere existence of same quality. Means here we don't use any other subjects to show the comparison, and sometimes we compare with the other person, but we show that it has the same quality as the we taken first subject. So and what is the formula is that here is the formula. First one, subject is MR plus adjective. Here adjective we can use, it's given in the bracket in the exam. They are giving you in the bracket, and it is many times used as fill in the blanks or in the positive way. We can write it as a subject 1 plus is MR as plus subject, sorry, as plus adjective plus as plus subject 2. Here consider that we have taken two subject, but we use as two times. So it means that the both of the person are same, and have the same quality, so it is called the positive degree. In the negative way, we can also use that, but in that we use the as of the as given before the adjective, we remove the as before the adjective and use the so instead of that. So the formula becomes like this: subject 1 is a mark plus not plus so plus adjective plus as plus subject 2. So you have seen that we use two subjects here also. That doesn't mean and we also use positive degree for the single subject also. So that doesn't mean that we can use it only for the one person or the one thing. We can use it for the two subject to show the equivalency. Here example is given: Riya is clever as Mundra. Here we use a two subject, Riya and Mundra. So here Riya is as clever as, so the cleverness is the quality and that is equal in the both Riya and Mundra. And in this negative way, we can say that Riya is not so clever as Mundra. Here we also compare that. Now second one is the comparative degree. It is, as I said earlier, that it is used to show the comparison between the two person or the two things, and its formula is the in a positive way: subject is MR, adjective, and after adjective we use ER or IER, and when we are using that, we will learn further. Plus than plus subject to, or in other way we can write that subject is MR plus more plus adjective plus than plus subject to. And when we use more, we will learn example of that is Peter is smarter than John. Here we use ER after the adjective smart, and we compare the Peter and John here. So the comparison is made between the two person, and we use to show comparative degree, we use the ER after the smart. And in the second sentence we can say, in the second example, mathematics is more difficult subject than English. Now when more is used, when the double syllabic word is used, we are using the more. And what is double syllabic word, that we will learn further. In the rules, there are 6 rules in the degree, and we will learn that. Now last one is the superlative degree. It is used to denote the highest degree of the quality. Means no one is like that. Like we can say that the Mount Everest, it is the highest peak of the world. Means no one is as high as the Mount Everest. So it is the example. And its formula is given here in a positive: subject 1. So sorry, here not subject 1 is come, here only one subject is used. Subject plus is MR the plus the plus adjective. If you remember that why we use the here, because it is the unique things. And in the articles I also taught you that the before the superlative degree we use the. So the is must before the adjective here. This is the most important thing here. So the formula is like that: subject is MR plus the plus adjective, and after adjective we use EST and IEST. And in the other way we can write subject plus is MR plus the plus most plus adjective. And example of that are given here: Rahul is the smartest boy in the class. It is same like the sentence we use in the comparative degree, but there we use the two subjects, Peter and John, and here we use the Rahul as a subject. And so the as the formula here, subject is Rahul, and after that we use is, and the is used before the adjective, and the smart is the adjective, and we use the EST after that, and boy in the class is the other words come. Iron is the most useful of the all metals. Here the useful is the double syllabic word, and that is why we use the most. So in the double syllabic word, more and most is used. We will learn about that in the rules. And Ritu is the prettiest girl in the neighborhood. Here prettiest is the adjective plus IEST, and it formula is as we learn. So here the rule comes. There are six rules in the degree. First of all, generally in the comparative degree we add the ER and after the adjective, and in the superlative degree we use EST after the adjective, and is in the positive degree only adjective we use, not a prefix or suffix we are using in that. So in a positive degree we had taken a tall as example, and in the comparative degree tall become taller, and in the when you use tall in the superlative degree it becomes the tallest. And same like that, old, older, oldest. Here if the word or the adjective ends with a E, we use only R in the comparative degree and ST in the superlative degree. So in the positive, the example of that is brave. So you can see that in the brave word or adjective, brave last end with a E, and in the comparative degree we only use a R after that, and in the superlative degree we use only ST because E is already given there, so we don't have to put the twice E in that. Fine. And the second example is fine, finer, finest. Now the third one is the most important. If the adjective ends in a single consonant in the base form, means if the last alphabet of the word is the consonant and the preceded by the vowel before the consonant, and in the alphabet before the last alphabet is the vowel, then the last alphabet is doubled before adding ER or EST. Means if the last letter is consonant and the letter before that is a vowel, then the last letter of the word is doubled, and then we can use the ER and EST as said earlier. So here is the first example of that. B big. Here we can see that the last letter G is a consonant and the letter before that is I, which is vowel. So the last letter G is doubled in the comparative and superlative degree, and then we use the ER and EST. Means in the comparative degree the word becomes BIGGER bigger, and in the superlative degree BIGGEST biggest. Similarly, like that, in example 2 we can use in a positive hot, second one is hotter, and superlative degree, in superlative degree we can say it hottest. Now this is the fourth rule. If an adjective ends with a Y in the base form means positive degree, and preceded a consonant before Y, then I is added instead of a Y and with a ER and EST. Means if the adjective or a word ends with a Y and it's the letter before the Y is a consonant, then the Y is omitted and instead of that we use the I, and ER and EST, and ER and EST are used as we said earlier. Example of that, ER and EST are used as said earlier. So example of that, dry in the positive, and we can see that in the last letter is a Y and before that we use a R, and in the comparative degree we omitted the Y and instead of that we use a I, and we use the ER as said earlier. And in the superlative degree we can see that by omitting Y and putting I instead, the dry become DRIEST, driest. Similarly, that lazy, lazier, and laziest. Now sometimes what is done, sometimes the last letter of the adjective is ends with a Y, but the preceded letter is a vowel, means from the A, E, I, O, U, then the I is not come and Y is not omitted. In that case, so we don't omit Y and don't add the I instead of that, and we remain with a Y. So we can here the example is given, gray, GREY. In that we can see that the last letter of the adjective is Y and it is preceded by the E, so the word becomes the GREY, and then the comparative we don't omitted the Y and use the ER, and in the superlative we use the EST. Now last one and the most important one come here, double syllabus adjective like the take more in the comparative, most in the superlative before. Now what is the double syllabic word? Here double syllabus is given, double syllabus adjective, or double syllabic adjective, or the double syllabic word, we can say that the when the some words are bigger and some, in that we stop in between of that. When we say that word and we have to stop between that, so for a small time, means in the nano or microsecond we have to stop, but we have to stop in that word, like a beautiful. In the beautiful we make a small pause between a beauty and fuel. Beautiful, when we are asking, then beautiful, then there is a small pause between a beauty and fuel and honest. So in the honest, so there is a small pause between O and nest, honest. So these are called the double syllabic word. And in the double syllabic word we use the more in the comparative degree and most in the superlative degree. Here the example are given also there. In the positive we use the honest, comparative degree more honest, and in the superlative degree it becomes the most honest. There are many words in there in which we use the more and most, like I said earlier that beautiful, intelligent is also double syllabic word. But similar synonyms of the intelligent, like clever is the single syllabic word. So we have here the lecture ends, and next time we will go with the tense. And if you like, then please like, share and subscribe our channel, PR Educational Zone. Thank you students.